Let's get some practice drawing cyclohexane chairs. We have one drawn here, and you can see right away that there's two distinct types of hydrogens on the cyclohexane chair. The ones that are drawn in yellow are pointing either straight up or straight down. Those are described as the axial positions, or the axial hydrogens in this case. And they're called that because if you imagine the axis, an axis going through the center of the cyclohexane, they would be parallel to that axis. When we go to draw this, we'll note that the chair is a zigzag, and the carbons that have a zigzag up have an axial straight up, and the carbons that are a zigzag down have an axial straight down. So you can see that they're alternating carbons. The other six hydrogens drawn in white are described as the equatorial hydrogens. Now these are ones that are either slightly down or slightly up, and they're described as equatorial because they go around the equator of the ring. So when we go to draw a cyclohexane chair, we'll notice that this is bond angle is for a tetrahedral carbon, 109.5, so that'll be out a little. And the other thing that I want to point out is that every bond drawn is going to, with the exception of the axial ones, which are straight up and down, every other bond is going to be parallel to another bond that's already been drawn. So for example, in the cyclohexane ring, this bond is parallel to this bond. And we also have these two bonds being parallel, and then the other two bonds, the other two sets of bonds, are parallel. Okay, so if we notice that in this drawing, that's going to help us draw a better cyclohexane chair. Okay, you can also notice that we have the letter W here. So this is a letter W, and back here we have the letter M. Here's a W. Here's an M. So when we compare the positions of these equatorial hydrogens and some of the carbon-carbon bonds in the structure, then we can look for some patterns that are going to help us draw a better cyclohexane chair. So let's put this up here for reference so we can keep an eye on it and get to drawing our own chair. So a good way to start, there's several different ways you can start, but one possibility is to start by drawing a little bit of a triangle like this. Then we're going to draw two parallel lines. Notice they're ending slightly staggered to one another. And then we're going to draw a second triangle. And remember that every new bond we're going to form is going to be parallel to some other bond. So this bond is going in this direction, so that's where our next angle goes. And then this bond is going to be parallel to this one. So that's going to be our cyclohexane chair. Now we want to draw in some, and don't be afraid to erase something and make some adjustments if you drew something and it doesn't look quite right. So now we want to draw in our hydrogens, but it's easy to start with the axial hydrogens because those are straight up or straight down. So here we have our three zigzag ups, so they're going to have hydrogens straight up. And then the other three carbons are zigzags down, and those are going to have hydrogen straight down. And remember that this representation by convention has this, these carbons on the bottom here are the front carbons, so this carbon is behind, and so we want to break that line to show that it's behind this carbon-carbon bond. So those are our axial hydrogens. Now we go to draw the equatorial hydrogens, and we're going to do so. They're going to be pointing slightly up or slightly down, and they're going to be parallel to some other bond that's formed. So if we start at the carbon on the far right here, we have an axial that's straight up, and if we draw about 109.5, it will look something like this, and you can see that this bond is parallel to this bond. Okay, and then we come down here, the bond. What you want to avoid is drawing the hydrogen straight across at a 90 degree angle. So this one is going to be, again, a little wider than 90. So keep in mind that every carbon is going to have one hydrogen that's in the up position and one that's in the down position. So if we have an axial that's straight up, then the equatorial is going to be pointing slightly down. If we have an axial straight down, the equatorial is going to be slightly up. So we can come to the other end and fill in those two as well. This hydrogen is going to be pointing down, and this hydrogen is going to be pointing up. And then I think these middle two carbons are usually the trickiest. Those are ones that cause some problems. But if you look for those M's and those W's, and keep in mind that it has to be parallel to some other bond, we're going to look at this bond. We're going to be parallel to this bond. And so we're going to draw it right here. And then up in this back carbon, we're going to draw it up in this direction so that it's parallel to this bond that's already shown. So that looks like a pretty good chair. Now another possibility is to not start with a zigzag at the bottom and go up, but we can start with a triangle like this, and then we're going to draw two parallel bonds going up, and then two going down. I'm not quite as good at drawing these chairs in this direction. So you can see that when you compare these two chairs, it's like you have a mirror image between the two. They have a different starting shape, and so that chair is just as good to draw. But again, if we wanted to fill in the hydrogens, we'll draw our six axial hydrogens, three straight up and three straight down. It's this back carbon that's going to be a broken bond. And then filling in our equatorial, we can start on the right end, go slightly up for this one and slightly down for the next one, and then jump to the other side, slightly down and slightly up. So you can see these equatorial hydrogens on the ends here kind of pointing toward each other. They're kind of pointing in toward each other. That is something else you can maybe be on the lookout for. And then those inside ones, we want to make it parallel to an existing bond. So this bond is parallel to this bond, and we see that M shape. And up here, we're going to make a W. We're going to draw this bond parallel to this bond. And we have that W shape going on. So there's a few different ways that we can draw some chair conformations. And the key is to just get some practice so that when we go to draw substituted cyclohexane chairs, in other words, once we put one or more substituent on the ring, we can place it very nicely in the appropriate position on each carbon. Maybe it's in the axial position, maybe it's in the equatorial position, but knowing where those positions are and what their relative stereochemistry is, what their relative shapes are and placements are, then we can draw very nice chairs moving forward.